amigos. Thank you for being here. Thank you for making it through another week. This is gratitude. Casa, Acantilado. It's on Pancho, Mexico. Music you hear in the background is a performance by me and Michael Mannering and Carl Weingarten at WXPN. Stars and Radio program. It was recorded about 3 in the morning to 4 in the morning, live. Thank you. spending part of the end of your week here with me. It's on Pancho, Mexico. Watch the sun go down. Towards Hawaii. Stay away from the bleach. There's a nice green flash right there. Green flash. I highly recommend later, if you play this back, you have some way to pause it right then. It looked pretty green to me here. Of course, I'm not looking through my iPad. I'm at Casa, Acantilado right here. That's where you're sitting with me. Dennis and Kim is here in San Pancho, Nayarit, Mexico.
Thank you.
Hope you all are feeling good tonight. Thanks for being here. Deeply appreciated. everybody's doing okay tonight. Welcome, Georgia. Sweet Georgia. I'm going to do a little play along with Jeff. Because why not?
Thank you.
Nice orange striped sky, hey? Well, that was an attempt at, I can't make you love me. Oh, perfect. This is a song called On Mother's Day. Actually, I'm gonna pause and tell you the story before you hear it. On Mother's Day is a track from my album, Next. It was written with Shambu and myself. And it came about in 2014 on Mother's Day. So Shambu created the guitar part down in San Diego. I created the horn part up in Alameda. And we liked the demo and we were gonna make a song out of it, so we did. And the session to record the horn part for that was on September 21st, which was a Monday. That year, on the 19th, my mom passed away at 85. So, as it turns out, already had scheduled long in advance, because Mother's Day, I think, is in, I don't know, May or June or something like that, the session. So we went in and it was a tribute to my mom, Phyllis Oster. So, and we recorded it, and it's called On Mother's Day.
Thank you.
To the moms. Let's do it again, just for fun. Well, sounds like it wants to be half a cookie. If I can get Venus to join the moon. I think we can, actually.
Let's see. There's the moon. There you go. Stay up there without breaking it here. Do it this way. That's right. Yeah. That's a nice combination, right? A little bit of the sun, Venus, the moon.
Why not? I mean, why not, right? Earl, man, I watched your drive down Tercer Mundo video the other day. Last night, actually. Earl Miller. And that was like an awesome trip down the main street of this little pueblo. Earl Miller did it. You should check him out. Back when it was Roberto's Bungalows, that's right. Which he's moved on from now. But he made a beautiful video. It's on YouTube. Of San Pancho. We'll drive a little tour down to the main street. So what you're seeing, can you see Venus? And I seem to be breaking out. I have some sort of a skin thing that's happening down here in Mexico. I'm not quite sure what it is. But it's pretty cool if you're on mushrooms. And then there's the moon. And then there's the sunset. Okay. That's penis. And the moon. Setting. Venus. And the moon. The mistakes too.
Venus. Say hello to the moon. Man, you could tell I totally love Pink Floyd. I mean, really, look at this. Right? Venus. Side of a rooster. Bark, 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 bark. Hello, Gaio. Bark, bark. Sinking into the sea. Let's take a look. Several species of small furried animals gathered together in a cave, grooving with a Pict. Harari Kree! Ring ding ding the Morgenstein!
Thank you.
Venus and the moon.
Thank you.
ocean. Venus is following it. I'm actually looking at a little bit of the moonshine on the water. So I think it's a little lower and then we'll lower the camera. And let's do a little whale moment, shall we?
Yeah. Hey.
It's probably not that good. You can't really see the reflection on the water, can you? Down here. Let's try this. Zoom in, see if that'll happen. No, it's a dream I'm having. Let's go back. Thank you. Venus and the moon. All right. Before I go, cheers. So I'll scoot a little closer here. One of the cool things that's been happening is that people, can you hear me okay? Can you hear me now? All right. What's doing that? All right, forget it. People have been doing a lot of writing. There's been a lot of interesting perspectives that have appeared. Some pretty cool memes. When there's the right amount of news. But I also believe there's some feeling that's also here. So I want to read you a couple things I found. If you are up for that, you could always turn it off though. It's totally up to me, isn't it? So here's one. If you've tuned in before, you've heard this before, but it bears repeating. Well, the angel. This is called The Gift. An imagined letter from COVID-19 to humans. Stop, just stop. It's no longer a request. It is a mandate. We will help you. We will bring the supersonic high-speed merry-go-round to a halt. We will stop the planes, the trains, the schools, the malls, the meetings, and the frenetic, furied rush of illusions and obligations that keep you from hearing our single and shared beating heart. The way we breathe together in unison, our obligation is to each other. As it always has been, even if, even though, you have forgotten. We will interrupt this broadcast, the endless cacophonous broadcast of divisions and distractions, to bring you this long breaking news. We are not well. None of us, all of us, are suffering. Last year, the firestorms that scorched the lungs of the earth did not give you pause. Nor the typhoons in Africa, China, Japan, nor the fevered climates in Japan and India. You have not been listening. It's hard to listen when you're so busy all the time, hustling to uphold the comforts and conveniences that scaffold your lives. But the foundation is giving way. Buckling under the weight of your needs and desires, we will help you. We will bring the firestorms to your body. We will bring the fever to your body. We will bring the burning, searing, and flooding to your lungs, that you might hear we are not well. Despite what you might think or feel, we are not the enemy. We are messenger. We are ally. We are a balancing force. We are asking you to stop, to be still, to listen, to move beyond your individual concerns, and consider the concerns of all. To be with your ignorance, to find your humility, to relinquish your thinking minds, and travel deep into the mind of the heart. To look up into the sky streaked with fewer planes, and see it, to notice its condition, clear, smoky, smoggy, rainy. How much do you need it to be healthy so that you may also be healthy? To look at a tree and see it, notice its condition. How does its health contribute to the health of the sky, to the air you need to be healthy? To visit a river, see it, notice its condition. Clear, clean, murky, polluted. How much do you need it to be healthy so you may also be healthy? How does its health contribute to the health of the tree, who contributes to the health of the sky so that you may also be healthy? Many are afraid now. Do not demonize your fear. And also do not let it rule you. Instead, let it speak to you. In your stillness, listen for its wisdom. What might it be telling you about what is at work, at issue, at risk, beyond the threats of personal inconvenience and illness? As the health of a tree, a river, the sky tells you about the quality of your own health, what might the quality of your health tell you about the health of the trees, the rivers, the sky, and all of us who share the planet with you? Stop. Just stop. Be still. Listen. Ask us what we might teach you about illness and healing, about what might be required so that all may be well. We will help you if you listen. I'm going to read one more if I can find it, and then I'm going to ask you a question. For those of you that are willing to play along, yeah, this is nice. Oh no, that's not it. Actually, all right. I know this is a mellow vibe, and I know I shouldn't bring politics into this, but if some of you follow me, some of you know I have opinions, a few. And I collect things and I share them and I post them. You know, like that. So let me find this really nice thing that I want to read to you. Just make sure I have it here. Pardon my blindness. I think it's in here. Yeah, it is. Okay. So I'm going to read this really nice thing at the very end tonight, but I'm going to read something in the middle that some people just lose it on the internet, especially on Twitter. They just can't help themselves. So if you don't like four-letter words, you probably want to tune out now, but if you can handle this, I'm going to read it to you. It's sort of a note from the general part of the population that is sick and tired of hearing what we're hearing. So this one person wrote, "Hey, do us all a favor and shut the fuck up. Shut the whole fucking fuck up. Shut the new extended 3-hour edition the fuck up. Once you've done that, put the bonus disc in and click the deleted fucks and shut those the fuck up. And once you have finished shutting the physical fuck up, redeem the code on the back, download the digital fuck from Amazon, and shut those up. Shut your 30-day free trial the fuck up. And once your mouth has receded into itself with such force from shutting the fuck up that your entire digestive system collapses into a black hole, shut the fuck up one more time for the betterment of humanity." Okay, I know a lot of you tuned out, but I thought that's funny as shit. All right, here we go. Here's a little more. This is much shorter than the last one. Not the second to last one, but the last one. The first one I read. Here it is. This is a nice one. "We fell asleep in one world and woke up in another. Suddenly Disney is out of magic. Paris is no longer romantic. New York doesn't stand up anymore. The Chinese wall is no longer a fortress and Mecca is empty. Hugs and kisses suddenly become weapons and not visiting parents and friends become an act of love. Suddenly you realize the power, beauty, money are worthless and can't get you the oxygen you're fighting for. The world continues its life, and it is beautiful. It only puts humans in cages. I think it's sending us a message. You are not necessary. The air, earth, water, and sky without you are fine. When you come back, remember that you are my guests, not my masters." So, there's Venus, the moon is sinking into the water right there. So, hi Michelle, hi Anna, hi everybody. Somebody, if you'd like, I can read the little print things now. I'll play one song at the very, very end, but ask me a question. Let's have a little conversation. You know, how's everybody doing? Anna, how are you? Applause right back to you. Buenas noches. Es muy bueno. Although I think you're from Brazil or something like that. Where's everybody? What's everybody doing? How's everybody doing? Rosa, Emilia, Figueredo. Did I say that right? It's close. How was everybody's week? Is it okay? I hope so. For those of you that are here, thank you for making it through another week. Hello, Lisa. All the way from Queensland. Will we be okay? I think we'd be. Yes, I do think that, actually. Hi, Michelle. Thank you for chilling here tonight. I'm glad. Feels good. Diane, glass of wine, glass of mezcal. Perfect. Super glad you're here. I'm in Mexico. Diane's somewhere up in Oregon. Jason, where are you? Connecticut? Nice. Well, I hope things get better everywhere. I'm down here to the end of next month. I've been here since February. Sort of hiding out, waiting for the lines at Trader Joe's to go away and for their toilet paper to return. And not have to freak out if I need a bottle of isopropyl alcohol. I was hearing some stories today, man, that were just like, really? Is that true? Like, no alcohol, no toilet paper, still. Wild. In Mexico, it's not like that. Down here in San Pancho, it's a town of about 1,500 people. And there's one road in, and the people that live here are volunteering 24 hours a day to stand at the front of the town and basically make sure that you live here or you can't come here. They're basically trying to protect everybody that lives here. Everything's closed. You get some things to go, and you can go to the pharmacy and get some gas. And the tiendas are open for some food, but man, this is when you drive down the main street here, Tercer Mundo, it is like 20 years ago. The beach is empty, guarded by Marines with machine guns. I like to run up to them and say, Oye, el pendejo, ¿qué pasó? I really don't do that. And I don't recommend it. Please don't do that to any Mexican Marine that you see. Don't run up and scream El Pendejo. Please, don't. My God. Next thing I know, you'll be mainlining, you know, Lysol or something. That's not a good idea either. So, I hope you all have a good weekend. Stay healthy. Wash your hands a bunch of times. I can't wait till we can hug each other again. Chicken, what does it mean? Oh, I see. What does El Pendejo mean? Yeah. Really? It starts with the number 45. No, let's go to the Google and see what El Pendejo means. Anybody that speaks Spanish is cracking up right now, but I'm going to read it. It'll be interesting to see what the web says. El Pendejo. If you ever want to look it up, it's L-P-E-N-D-E-J-O. Let's see. Oh, this will be good. You guys will probably laugh. This is from dictionary.com. Ready? It's a mildly vulgar insult for asshole or idiot in Spanish. But wait, there's more. Pendejo is a staple of Spanish language insults. Though milder than hijo de puta, son of a bitch, pendejo is a singular masculine noun. The feminine is pendeja. The word pendejo comes from a Latin root meaning pubic hair. In the 16th century Spain, pendejo was apparently first used to describe pubescent teens who thought they were adults. You know, because they had pubes. In the 17th century, pendejo came to mean coward, a mocking or taboo reference. After conquest and colonization, Spanish became the common language in much of the Americas, where it evolved from its European parent by the early 1900s. Pendejo had drifted from coward to insulting someone dumb or stupid, tonto, in the Americas. Who uses pendejo? Pendejo is used throughout the Spanish-speaking countries, especially popular in Mexico and those of Mexican heritage living in the United States. In areas with large numbers of Spanish speakers, like the American Southwest, it's not uncommon to hear the word pendejo used in an otherwise English-language conversation, especially by those of Spanish heritage at the border talking to an ICE agent.
A number of Mexican sayings involve pendejos, or idiots. For instance, there is the pessimistic proverb, amor de lejos, amor de pendejos, or love from afar, love for pendejos. Go get your boo. Pendejo is generally an insult, with the force of the English asshole or jerk. But it can have a friendly tone to it as well, depending on context. For example, you might say to your friend, listen, pendejo, I'll tell you. In Argentina and a few other places in Latin America, pendejo is used to refer informally to young men or boy who tries to act older than he is, a throwback to the original use of the word in Spain. While pendejo is most commonly used by Spanish speakers or people of Latino heritage, pendejo is a familiar and common has been adopted by a number of American English speakers, regardless of heritage, like this little Jew boy right here. I bet you like to lick people's shoes, pendejo. Wow. That's how it ended. I didn't make it up. Note, this is not meant to be a formal definition of pendejo like most terms we define on dictionary.com, but it's a rather informal word summary that hopefully touches upon the key aspects of the meaning and usage of pendejo that will help our users expand their word mastery. So tonight, I hope we've mastered the word pendejo. Beautiful, right? All right. Any other words you'd like to know the meanings of tonight, since we happen to be on a moment like that? Don't all rush to the front of the chat line. All right. Now I'm going to play another pretty new age song. Now that I've read everything else having to do with my other side of life. You understand that people that play really soft music like this, there's a whole other side. Did you know that? There is. Whole other side. The good news for me is, when I have my horn in my mouth, I can't talk. So I'm required to speak through this, which I won't do now. Let me think. Play My Funny Valentine. It's a nice one. Standard, you know. I only know like four of them. That's nice. All right, thank you for being here tonight, everybody. Bye. Oster. Pizza a couple nights. A gigante size one. Somebody ask a question. Just one. Uno. I say question. Dear God, I should know this. Pregunta? What it is? Uno pregunta, por favor. Pregunta, pregunta, is that how you say it? Are those fireflies? Man, I wish they were fireflies. They're my spacey Royal Galaxian laser lights. Una pregunta, por favor. What am I missing most right now? Wow. The ability to touch somebody and see them without their mask on. I miss seeing a smile walking on the street. That's what I miss. I miss touch. I miss the smell of hair. Not my own. What else? What do you all miss most? John, that's a good question. Hola, Monica. Say hello to your mom for me. The one and only. Yeah, right? Somebody smiling? This whole bump elbow thing is bullshit. Necessary, but bullshit. It's difficult. What else do you miss now in our current world? So much different than the world 4 months ago, right? Hasn't been that long, has it? Hello, Cheryl. Thank you for being here tonight. Obama. Yeah, no kidding. Well, maybe we'll have somebody who knows him. What is the first thing you do when you get up in the morning now? What is the first thing you do when you get up in the morning, besides open your eyes? Now that you don't have to rush to go out to the office, what do you do? Bernie, how are you, my friend? Bernie owns an Aston Martin, a lot different than a Jaguar. P, yes, that's good. My problem is there's probably 5 or 6 times during the night that I take care of that, so that might not be the first thing for me. Coffee, yes. What do you put in your coffee, Jason? If anything. And what kind of coffee? Dark? Flavored? Yes, Lisa, that is the truth right there. Yeah, I have one of these apps that tracks how you sleep, and sadly, it also records if you snore. I'm glad that I don't sleep next to me. That's all I have to say. And if I slept next to me, I would have earplugs and white noise and some sort of mantra playing. Cream and sugar, dark, yeah, that's good. That's nice. I like to put in my coffee. I'm glad you're alive too, believe me. I like to put whipping cream, a little bit. I like to put coconut oil, and I like to put monk fruit sugar. When I don't have monk fruit sugar, a tiny bit of honey. Love it. Dark coffee, the darker the better. Same with the beer. A positive intention, that's good. What? I don't know what. Hola, Gina Lene. No beer here. No, there is not, is there? Who knew that in Mexico, the two things that they would close, they close the beach, and they close the stores where you can buy beer and tequila. Really? Hola, Gina. Gina Lene is a fabulous piano player. Yeah, that's crazy, right? It's not essential, since when is beer and tequila not essential? All the toilet paper you need, though. I'm running around, you know, wrapping houses and trees in front of houses just because I can. I'm just kidding. Nobody wants Corona. Yeah, well, you know, I think that the marketing people at Corona Beer got together and hired an ad agency, and they said, you know, we wanted you to create a viral marketing program, but we didn't have this in mind. We did not have this in mind. That's for sure. Tell you what I'm going to do. Come right back here in a minute. You can have both there. Yeah, well, Australia, I can't imagine that they would stop alcohol consumption there. You know, flat out like a lizard drinking and all that. Be right back. Can you hear the ocean? Man, I wish you guys could see this. The moon is set. And you see that white dot there? That's, you can hear the ocean? Awesome. Best soundtrack of all. But that's Venus right there. Look how bright. And course, the camera doesn't do it justice, but you can actually see Venus reflecting off of the ocean. It's a trip. It's a trip. Oh, you can hear the ocean? I'll shut up for a minute. I'm here. Oh, where did I go? You mean when I just walked away? Well, I cannot tell a lie. I went to get some more mezcal. That's what I did. And now I have some more. But it might be a good moment to play a little more. Since many of you are still here, thank you. Pretty friggin' cool, actually. Ben, I'm here until the end of May. Then I'm coming back, and hopefully by the end of May, I'll be a lot out of my house there, you know. Are there coqui frogs? I don't know what that is. I know down in Puerto Vallarta there's a senior frogs, but I don't roll like that. No frogs here that I've heard. I mean, I imagine there are. You know what there are, though, coming up soon when it starts to rain, is that there are red crabs that come out of the jungle, go down to the water to mate. So they tend to crawl through houses, across your face when you sleep, and things like that. Can't wait. Hope it rains, just so I can experience waking up with a red crab working its way towards the ocean. All right. Thank you.